Now we are starting to train the long down for Ganga. All my other dogs understand the long down. Ganga does not understand it. So I'm going to start training the long down. So what I have is a piece of bread. Please don't ask me whether bread is healthy and all that. I do not know. I just use what I have. I am not a veterinarian. Just some food that the dog can eat. Okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to feed those dogs that are lying down between their legs. And Ganga can do whatever he wants. He is not going to get any food until he lies down. So he can do whatever the hell he wants. Carry it, come on. Carry it, go. Good boy. So until such time he lies down, he is not going to get any food. Good. And I'm going to feed between his legs. And as long as he is lying down, I am going to keep the frequency of his treats as high as possible. So it is not like he is going to get only one treat, or rather one piece of bread. He will get multiple pieces of bread for every one piece that the other dog gets, because I want him to understand that lying down is a very rewarding activity. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to place the food here. So and the moment he gets up, I'm going to take it off. And while this piece of food is still here, okay, I'm going to take it off. That's good. Now you know what happens, right? When he gets up, I take the food away. And when he lies down, I'll keep the food down and I'll take my hand up and I will reward him with another piece of food between his legs while this piece of food is still there. So when he comes, I will take it away, that's all. So now he has gone to square one. It's like snake and ladders. He has gone to square one. He is not going to get anything. Now he will get something, but first he has to understand that there will be food here. And that does not mean that he can rush and take that food. So just to tempt him some more, I'm going to place another piece of food here, a little bit closer. So far I have used only one slice of bread for four dogs. So that is the amount of food you need. See, this is the size of the treat. If you want to call it a treat, it's just something for the dogs to understand that hey, I'm just getting a reward. Curry has not been feeling well for the past few days. Only today he's eating well, so I'm quite happy about that. And again, I'm going to drop another piece of food here, and I'm going to prevent him from taking it. Good boy, Ganga. Sri Ram, are you catching this here? See, lots of pieces of food here, and this little guy is resisting, so he is going to get rewarded between his legs. My little Bumi is drooling because she wants the bread as well, but she is such a sweet girl, she is not complaining. It's okay, good boy. So for every piece I drop, I give him a reward. And I will never let him get up and access that piece of food. unless I have the confidence that I can prevent him from taking that piece of food, I should not embark upon this exercise. Now I'm going to take all this food away. And reward him with another piece of food. Good boy. I'm going to reset him now. I'm going to make him stand up so that he has another opportunity to sit down. Now I have set him up for failure again because he won't get any food while the others will get food now. He will not get any food and I purposely made him stand up so that he understands that he will not get any food. So I'm just going to keep feeding them round robin.
Good boy, there you go.
I think this is the third slice of bread amongst 3.5 dogs. Now I'm going to drop these pieces of food here. Just to let Ganga know that just because the food is here, he cannot access it. Bhumi is drooling. So now I'm going to pick up all this and use it to feed them so that they understand. I mean, all my other puppies understand. This fellow is a new fellow, so he does not understand the meaning of the long down, but soon he will. Just look at Curry, how relaxed he is. The reason why Curry has been slow in the past few videos is because he was not feeling well. Only today he is eating well and all that, so there is nothing wrong with him. Do you notice that I always feed him on the ground while I feed my other dogs? However I please, but with Ganga, I always feed him on the ground. So he didn't get anything there, so I'm going to take a little bit more and give him. Can you see the dilemma he is facing? He knows that this position is more rewarding, so he is refusing to break that position. Yes. So he is not willing to get up. He is not falling for my little trick. I tricked him initially by making him get up. See, there I failed. I should not have done it. He is refusing to fall for my trick. Okay. So that was a failure on my part. I should not have let it happen. Since I threw that treat too far away from me, I could not prevent him from eating it. Ganga, daddy, let's go. Good boy. Smart boy. Again, I have set him up into a position where he is not going to get treated. I hope you understand what I am doing here. Yes. If I were to teach him to down, which I will show in another video, I will feed him on the ground all around him so that he can get up more often. With a long down, it's a little bit different. So there is a big difference between teaching the dog the long down and teaching the dog to down. They are two different things. Not entirely two different things, but kind of different. I'll demonstrate that to you in the coming videos. Okay, so that was the exercise for today. I think four slices of bread. For those who are really keen on what bread it is, what I'm feeding, it is modern bread. Oats and flax. I hope modern bread gives me some money for plugging their product. It's got nothing to do with it. Just give your dog something the dog likes. That's all. So I hope it was of some use to you. click the like button and subscribe button and the bell icon if you like it. Thank you.